KRM22 has announced its half-year trading update. To talk us through the highlights, we're joined by Keith Todd, Chairman and Chief Executive. So Keith, first up, key messages. What are the key messages in this update?
Well, it's been a period where we made good progress and the outlook looks very good, excellent. But frankly, frustration as well. And that might be a strange thing to say in these updates, but it's just one of the realities of business life. An example, you know, we've got £600,000 worth of recurring revenue, multi-year contracts that are, and that's the annual amount of the contracts that have been agreed, not signed. And they didn't quite fall over the sort of the right side of the half year. So they're coming, but not quite there. So a little frustrating on that point. And then we had a couple of situations with customers where their business approach had changed and they didn't renew the contract. They were legacy or historic customers. And that's always a challenge for a business. The key thing is strategically taking these steps forward to be able to build out the range of what we want to do as a software as a service company in the capital markets.
I'm just wondering about how important the quality of the customers are, strengthening the quality of the customers, Keith.
Well picked up. We refer to that in our announcement, and it is really important. It's probably worth me just clarifying what we mean by that. And there's a number of factors. I said a moment ago about as a software as a service company, do we like to host in our private environments the delivery of the service? Because it's better for customers, it's better for us, more margin for the business and better performance. Secondly, we really want to establish what we call master services agreements. Because if we've got one deal for one product, by having a master service agreement, it's an order form. The next contract is just another order form. No, wrong to say no, but much less negotiation. So software as a service, getting master services agreement. And another piece of the transition is in the quality of customers is about the length of contracts and the termination conditions. Many of the historic contracts we inherited were deployed software on site and short termination notices. And the final thing is really important to say is every customer is important to us. But there is no doubt, and the world knows this, the larger customers can spend more money with us, which is good for our revenue and good for our profits going forward. People talk about share of purse. So that is why we have been putting this effort to go for the tier one banks, for example. Frustrating as it may be, it takes time, but it means that you've got access to a bigger purse and greater opportunities for the future.
Hey, let me just pick one of those words you used then, good. Now, how good is your risk platform? I know it's been expanded. Can you explain a little bit more about that?
Yes, well, the people listening to this may have been aware of us before, but for new people, we deliver everything through what we know as our global risk platform. And on that platform, it's accessed through the internet, on a private line, or through the internet, you get access to a series of applications, a bit like you would on the phone, except these are all aimed at risk. And behind the scenes, we integrate the data flows. So the platform we have means that once a customer has got access to them, they have a lot of optionality to take other offerings. And that is why another set of words I use a lot is the global risk platform known as GRP is a springboard for growth. Because once a customer is established on it, and we have there, for example, trade and order data to at trade manage them, we can then run our stress tools on them. We can then run our surveillance tools on them. And over time, we can grow the amount of income we get from that type of customer across the suite.
So what about the future? Are you going to be negotiating the future from inside your risk cockpit, as it were?
Well, it's a very, very important product that we have, without doubt. And when we first launched the company, the central gravity of this was about the integration of risk components. And the metaphor of the cockpit comes from the pilot world. The pilot has around him all of the information that could possibly be a risk to that flight. And our whole ethos is that, yes, whilst we need individual instrumentation applications for pre-trade risk, post-trade risk, stress, surveillance, compliance, cybersecurity, actually, you need to bring these all together. We've already been announced recently some new partnerships because, reminder for the listeners here, we build our own software, but we bring partner products on. We got a very exciting announcement going to be made around holistic surveillance. And those practitioners will say, well, holistic surveillance has been around for a while. But I'm going to suggest when we do announce it a little bit detail later on, that perhaps it hasn't been quite as complete as it should have been. And that by bringing together our partner suite, we'll be able to very shortly announce a very compelling product to really, I think, transform the surveillance marketplace. And that's in addition to where you started this conversation around the cockpit. It's really emerged as not just a tool for the capital markets, but for any business to help bring together the risks the business face together with the management information on how the business is doing. And the listeners may be interested to know, I use it every day myself. In the screen just over next to me is my cockpit with all my dashboards, all my key metrics for KRM22 being updated in live action. So anybody listening out there, if they're not in the capital markets, feel free to also contact us. But it's a very compelling product. This is going to help transform the way businesses are managed from a daily point of view as well as risk.
Crikey, Keith. Fancy leaving us on that transformational cliffhanger. I can't wait for that announcement to come out. Keith Todd, Chairman and Chief Executive of KRM22. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you, Sarah.